a laser?
Lasers, they're cool. They invoke futuristic spaceships and epic space battles. But if we're not under attack from aliens, then why in the universe are ESO's telescopes firing giant laser beams into the sky? For years, astronomers have been fighting an enemy up in the skies. But it's not aliens. It's our own atmosphere. And lasers are proving to be a game changer. Now, don't get me wrong. As a human, I love our atmosphere. It contains the oxygen we need to breathe and also prevents us from being grilled by the sun's radiation. But as an astronomer, I have a big problem with it. See the way the stars twinkle? That is caused by turbulence in the atmosphere. And while it makes for a beautiful view, it leads to blurry images and distorted observations. Luckily, there is a way to magically remove much of the effect of our atmosphere without us suffocating in the process. Adaptive optics. Adaptive optics uses cool things such as lasers and shape-shifting mirrors to correct for the distortions. It works a bit like noise-cancelling headphones, but for light rather than sound waves. So, how does it work? First, you need to figure out exactly how much the atmosphere is distorting the light from the astronomical image that you want to observe. For this, you need a benchmark. A bright and stable star close to your object. Its light is captured by a wavefront sensor, which is an array of tiny lenses and a detector divided into small areas. Without any turbulence, each tiny lens creates an image of the star in the center of the respective detector area. So we end up with lots of dots perfectly aligned with each other. But when turbulence distorts the light, these dots are offset from their central positions. These offsets are measured and sent to a computer that performs some super fast calculations to determine exactly how the signal needs to be corrected. These instructions are then fed to a thin, deformable mirror, which reflects the light of the astronomical object before it is recorded. Like a lake reflecting the mountains surrounding it, the exact shape of the mirror influences how much the image that you get is distorted. So, by changing the shape of the mirror in exactly the right way, we can effectively cancel out the turbulence. But the atmosphere is a tricky opponent. Turbulence changes very rapidly, on the order of 1,000 times per second. That means that our mirror needs to change its shape just as quickly. The secret to this lies underneath its thin surface. Adaptive mirrors are only a couple of millimeters thick and rest on hundreds of computer-controlled actuators, which can make the mirror move and change its shape very quickly. All of this requires state-of-the-art technology, and is a major effort on the computing and engineering side. But it's worth it. Using adaptive optics, we can study fainter images and make out finer details in the images, almost as if we were in space. Instead of this, we get this. But what does all of this have to do with lasers? Well, remember that for adaptive optics to work, we need a bright star as a benchmark. The problem is, there may not be one close enough in the sky to the astronomical object that we want to observe. So we need to make our own by shooting a laser up into the sky. The laser excites sodium atoms in a layer of the atmosphere about 90 kilometers up, which is nearly in space. The sodium atoms start to glow, creating a temporary artificial star. And hey presto! The adaptive optics system can perform its magic and remove the blurring no matter where we point the telescope. But of course, a laser like this just isn't going to cut it and get all the way up to 90 kilometers. The lasers used on ESO's telescopes are about 4,000 times stronger and bright enough to create a point-like star high up in the atmosphere. As a pilot, I must admit that that's slightly worrying. Much less powerful lasers have been used to blind people flying airplanes. This is why ESO's VLT has an aircraft avoidance system, which shuts down the laser automatically if an aircraft gets too close to the beam. And of course, we always make sure to point one telescope's laser in such a way that it doesn't interfere with the observations of another telescope. I hope I've managed to convince you that a telescope launching a laser is a useful thing. But why does the VLT need four? Well, turbulence varies even over small patches of the sky. So the more lasers and the more artificial stars you have, the larger the patch of sky you can unblur, and the better your image. The VLT is set to soon gain some more lasers, so stay tuned. ESO's extremely large telescope, which is currently under construction just a few kilometers from the VLT, will have a whopping 6 lasers, and the most sophisticated adaptive optics system ever used on a telescope, including several types of wavefront sensing cameras and the largest shape-shifting mirror ever built, more than twice the diameter of current adaptive optics mirrors. All of this means that once it comes online later this decade, the ELT will make images 6 times sharper than the James Webb Space Telescope, despite having to battle the atmosphere. So, in the epic battle of the skies, the final score reads, astronomers 1, atmosphere 0.